You had a rough time, did you not, with Johnny Carson?
I did.
Because he made fun of you too much?
Well, what happened is I had done his show many, many times and considered him a friend of mine. And all of a sudden, a whole new brand of humor started to be displayed by him. And he was in that humor, questioning my masculinity.
Implying you were gay?
Yes, he was. And
did you call him? Or?
I called his agents. I called his manager. I called his attorney. I went through probably a year and a half of trying to reach him. And when none of that worked, I went to see him.
And? No, you know, I'm not going to leave it there.
I went to NBC, Burbank, and walked down the halls into his office. And Freddie DeCordova, his producer, was in the office with him. And I walked in unannounced, and I said to Freddie, I said, would you excuse us, please? He was so shocked that he did get up and leave. And I said to Mr. Carson, I said, I don't know what friend of yours I've killed. I don't know what child of yours I've hurt. I don't know what food I've taken out of your mouth. But these jokes about me will stop, and they'll stop now, or I will kick your ass. It doesn't.
And what did he say?
He started to mumble, and I think he said something like, Wayne, I'm your biggest fan. I said, don't give me that crap. Don't give me that. I am here to straighten out whatever your problem is. And whichever way you want to straighten out, it's fine with me.
Do you think he was using just...
Sure.
He wanted more jokes than...
I'm going to say something I've never said on television, Mr. King. Johnny Carson was a mean-spirited human being. And there are people that he has hurt that people will never know about. And for some reason, at some point, he decided to turn that kind of negative attention toward me, and I refused to have it.
Do you think it hurt your career?
In retrospect, no. I think that probably there was a time that it could have hurt my career, but I think ultimately the whole thing that evolved later on in around 1980, where I was accused of fronting for the mafia and being a member of the mafia and then being extorted by the mafia and all of that emanated from Johnny Carson's influence.
You think, yeah?
I know so, yes.
Now, Sinatra had that same bum rap, too, in
well,
the image.
I can tell you that when it started with me, my name was put on a hit list, which was told to me by the FBI. And they said the six people on this list, five of them are dead.
Who would want to hit you?
Well, because NBC had said that I was going to be a star witness against the mafia in court.
Oh.
I don't know anything about it. I'm an Indian boy from Virginia. You know, I don't know about that kind of stuff.
Well, you didn't get killed.
I didn't get killed, and the FBI handed me a bulletproof vest and said, call us if anything happens.